Let me bring Bianca Goladriga in right now. Bianca, moments ago you spoke with the father of Zokar.
Yeah, I did. I was surprised I even got through in Georgia. He must have just been in shock because he wasn't screaming. We spoke on the phone for about 10 to 15 minutes. He told me that he had not expected this to happen, obviously. He had two sons and two daughters, both, all four living in the U.S., the two daughters living in New York, the sons in Boston. Tamerlan, as we found out, is a father himself, the elder of the suspects, who we now know is dead. He has a three-year-old daughter. This, of course, all coming from the man who told me on the phone that he was their father on Zokar. The three-year-old granddaughter's name is Zahara. Tamerlan was married as well, and of course, obviously, all concern and focus now is on his younger son.
I know he believes that his sons were set up, but he also had a very important message for his son on the loose, if he's listening.
That's right. I asked him, if your son is watching right now, what would you want to tell him? And he said, give up. Give up. You have a bright future ahead of you. Come home to us. Come home in Russia. But George, he's also convinced that his sons were not involved in this. He says they are good boys. They've never known to carry or train with guns or any sort of weapons at all. All of this a huge surprise to him.
He told him his older son had been killed.
Yes.
And his response?
And he was in shock. And what shocked me was that he said he had just spoken with his sons a few days ago after the apparent bombings went off. And he said that his sons were not there. They knew nothing about it. They were very calm and said, Dad, we don't frequent these type of events.
But if his son was killed?
If his son was killed, he said that he is devastated and he thinks they did it to him. He kept calling it them, the perpetrators.
Bianca Goladriga, thanks very much.